If you visit my YouTube channel, then under the popular uploads, you will see how to blur part of the video is most watched video. And under this video, few viewers have asked me if I can make similar tutorial for desktop version of the CapCut app. If we go to the official website of the CapCut, then you will see there are three types of app available. CapCut Web is web-based online editor. So basically inside the Chrome web browser, you can do the video editing, but it has some limitations because it does not support the keyframe. So today's tutorial will not work if you are using the CapCut Web. CapCut app is, let's say, available for iOS and Android. I already have the tutorial just like I showed you in the beginning. So you can watch that if you are using the mobile app. And the third one is CapCut for Windows. So basically it is the desktop version for the Windows PC. I think for Apple users, it is also available on MacBook. So you need to go to the Apple App Store and there you can find the CapCut desktop version. So click on download for Windows to download it and then install it on your PC. So let's get started with actual tutorial. Once the CapCut app is installed on your Windows PC, double click it to open it. And the initial window should look like this. You need to sign in using Google, Facebook or TikTok account inside the CapCut app. Otherwise, there will be a CapCut watermark on your exported videos. So if you do not want that watermark, please create account and sign in just like I have done it here. To start the project, click on Start Creating and it will open this window. If you want the in-depth tutorial about the CapCut desktop version, then please write in the comment section, because in today's tutorial, I'm not going to talk about all these buttons, what they do. I'm going to show you only how you can blur some part of your video. Now to start editing your project, you need to import the video on which you want to work. So you can click on import button or you can just drag the video and drop it inside the project like this. If I move my mouse over the video, then you can see there is a plus button. So if I click on it, add to track, it will be added to the timeline, or I can hold the video and drag it to the main track like this and it will be added to the timeline. As we want to blur some part of the video, we need the overlay layer. And to have the overlay layer, you can right click the original video, copy it, and here you can just click and then paste like this. So now you have the main track video and the overlay video. And if you want to know all the shortcuts, you can click here on the shortcut button and it will show you all the shortcuts. Now go to the effects and under the basic, you will find the blur effect. If I click on it, it will show you the preview. And here also there is a plus button. So if I click on it, it will be added on the timeline, but this blur effect is being applied to both videos. So overlay video as well as the main track video. And this is not what we want, because we want to just blur only some part of the video and not the whole video. So I will select it and delete it. If you want to apply the effect to only one of the video, either the overlay or only the main track, then in that case, you have to right click and hold the effect and drag it over the video to which you want to apply. So in our case, we want to apply it to the overlay video. So I will drag and drop over that video. And as you can see, the effect blur has been applied and you can also adjust the duration of that effect. And on the right hand side, you can change the intensity of the blur. So I will just keep it around 80 and leave it like that. And suppose if I click away, then you can see you can't see the effect. Even if I click on the overlay video, I'm not able to see the blur effect. And to bring it back, you need to right click on it and then click on edit effects and it will be then shown. Now click somewhere else and then select the overlay video again. On the right hand side, you will see different tabs, basic, cutout and mask. So select the mask tab. Here you will see different types of masks like circle, film strip, rectangle and so on. So depending upon the situation, you have to select the shape. For example, if you want to blur the face, then you need to select the circle shape. But here we want to blur the number plate, so I am going to select the rectangle. So when I click on it, it will be downloaded and applied. As you can see, inside of the rectangle is blurred, outside is clear. We can, let's say, invert this effect by clicking on this reverse button. So outside will be blur and inside will be clear. But we want other way around, so I will just switch it back. You can then adjust the size of this rectangle by dragging these handles like this. So as we want to blur the number plate, so I will reduce the size to match it to the number plate like this. You can change the mask parameters from the right hand side, like position XY. You can rotate it, you can change the length and the width of this rectangle and so on. If I preview or play the video, then you can see number plate is not staying at one place and eventually it will be visible as our mask, blur mask is staying at one place. So we need to also move that or animate it, and that can be done using the keyframes. And the keyframe is nothing but this diamond shape. So if I add it or I click on add keyframe, then it will be added, and you can see there's a blue color diamond shape added here. If I move my timeline till the number player is visible, and then I can adjust my mask position like that, and another keyframe will be automatically added. So the mask is also moving now, as you can see, between these two keyframes like this. So I will quickly add all the keyframes or adjust my blur mask position according to the number plate quickly. As you can see on the overlay video, there are a lot of diamond shapes. They are nothing but the keyframes. So let's preview the video. And as you see, as the number plate is moving, our blur mask is also moving according to its position. And this can be achieved using the keyframes. And that's how you can blur some part of the video. Let's say you want to blur more than one part of the video, so not only number plate in this example, but also the Volkswagen symbol, then you need to basically follow the same procedure. So I will move the timeline at the beginning, right click the main video, copy it, and then again paste it. Obviously it is pasted between the initial two videos, but you can move the layers up and down to adjust the position, it doesn't matter. And then you can hold the blur effect, drag and drop over the another copied layer like this. Then increase the intensity of the blur to the value you want, so 80. Select the video like this, go to the mask and apply the circle like this. You can adjust the size of this circle to match to the symbol of the Volkswagen like that. And again, when the car is moving, you can add the keyframe and adjust the position of the mask for that. And that's how you can blur multiple parts of the video, just like I showed you. So you need to just copy the original video, apply the blur effect on top of that, and change the position of the masking. To export the video, click on the export button. In the title, you can rename the file name, then you can also change the location where you want to export the video. At the bottom, there are different video settings such as resolution, frame rate, format, and so on. On the left hand side, I have clicked the remove watermark, so basically it will remove the watermark. But if I move my mouse over the question mark, then you can see that you need to be logged in into the CapCut, otherwise the watermark will not be removed. And if you click on the export button, the video will be exported. If you like this tutorial, then please click on the like button, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find the playlist for more CapCut related tutorials, which are useful for desktop version as well as to the mobile version. Thanks for watching, stay safe and stay healthy.